We're following a disturbing new twist in the COVID pandemic. Anti-Semitic flyers filled with COVID conspiracy theories popping up in cities around the United States, including Miami Beach. CNN's Leyla Santiago is there for us.
Tonight, a community on alert, an investigation underway to find out who is behind the hate-filled flyers delivered to more than 200 Miami Beach homes. Officials say the flyers left in the middle of the night, targeting the Jewish community, falsely claiming the public health response to COVID is being orchestrated by Jewish people.
At first, I thought it was targeted to me, until I started, you know, just looking around and seeing every house was. So this is kind of like shocked a lot of people that have lived on the island for over 50 years.
We're already living in a moment where we've seen a remarkable rise in anti-Semitic incidents. We have about double the number of acts of harassment, vandalism, and violence today than we did just a few years ago. And this weekend, we had these anti-Semitic flyers dropped in six different states.
Over the weekend in San Francisco, police officers collected flyers with some of that same anti-Semitic language. In Colorado, flyers now under investigation distributed in Denver. The ADL also reports flyer distribution in Wisconsin, Maryland, and Texas over the weekend. Meanwhile, at a rally in D.C., anti-vaccine activist Robert F. Kennedy Jr.
Even in Hitler Germany, you could cross the Alps into Switzerland. You can hide in an attic like Anne Frank did.
He has since apologized. Even his wife tweeted, "My husband's reference to Anne Frank at a mandate rally in D.C. was reprehensible and insensitive. The atrocities that millions endured during the Holocaust should never be compared to anyone or anything. His opinions are not a reflection of my own." The Anti-Defamation League reports a sharp increase over the last decade in anti-Semitic incidents. Back in South Florida, the dangerous rhetoric concerning city leaders and residents.
I think this is not something you can brush off. This is not, oh, well, what kind of crime was committed? I don't care if we charge them with littering. These people need to be held accountable. You don't drive into our town and throw your garbage onto our lawns.
And Wolf, I am in the neighborhood tonight where this actually occurred, where these flyers were handed out. And I got to tell you, there's a strong sense of fear and vulnerability when you talk to neighbors, even a local rabbi. But there's also a strong desire to call this out for what it is, to call this out for being hate. Miami Beach police telling us tonight they are working with the FBI to get to the bottom of this.
Hope they do. Leyla Santiago in Miami Beach, thank you very much. Let's discuss with the mayor of Miami Beach, Dan Gelber. Mayor, thank you for joining us. As you know, Miami Beach police say they've now collected, more than 200 of these anti-Semitic letters. So what are you learning about who potentially is behind these very disturbing and dangerous flyers?
Well, obviously, it's pretty disgusting. Thanks for having me, Wolf. This is an important issue. Because you can't just sit around and ignore it or hide from it. You have to speak out against it. And we intend to do that. Our police are investigating it with local and federal authorities. Fortunately, the folks that are responsible for this, their hate was only rivaled by their stupidity because, you know, we're a community with a lot of cameras around. People have security cameras, guard gates. So I'm pretty confident we will identify these folks if we haven't already. And whatever we can do, we are going to do, because our community isn't going to just sit around and say, do what you want. We have to speak out very strongly against this.
I'm sure you have a lot of leads right now, and I'm sure you'll follow up very diligently. You said you just can't assume this is harmless stupidity. So what actions, Mayor, are you taking to ensure the Jewish community in Miami Beach is protected?
Well, I was on my morning Sunday walk with my wife, and we saw these scattered around our neighborhood. Our police immediately went to temples and houses of worship to increase their patrols. We have a pretty good, system with our own rabbis and priests, and we sent out word very quickly that they should be vigilant. I mean, look, the truth is, it's flyers, but it's from people who are vitriolic in their hate. So, you know, when you see something like this in your own neighborhood in front of your house, you just sort of wonder, well, is the next thing going to be a rock? And then is the next thing after that going to be something even more deadly? So we don't take it lightly. We take it extremely seriously. And we don't ignore it and pretend like it's just, stupid behavior. It's threatening behavior.
Certainly is. Miami Beach Mayor Dan Gelber, thanks so much for joining us.